How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator Classic. And today, folks, I'm going to be using my workshop created scenario. I did make this one myself, and it is available to download and use from the Steam Workshop. And this one, folks, is the P40DC in the Amtrak Phase 3 livery. This was released earlier this year, and this one here, folks, is 834. And to be quite frankly honest, I do like the cab view, even though the model does look like it's been converted from Microsoft Train Simulator, in my opinion. But I like the cab view, and I like the rolling stock, and that's the reason why I purchased this add-on earlier in the year. Anyway, folks, let's release the brakes. Let's get the train all set up then, shall we? And then let's get ready for service. I have added this train as NPC traffic, and this scenario just uses the default stock that comes with the Arizona Divide route. So that's very straightforward. And let's have some fun then, folks, shall we? Oh, by the way, folks, just want to let you know that the controls are a wee bit different on this train. As for those of you who may remember back in the days of Microsoft Train Simulator, you have to use D to increase power and use A to decrease power and apply the dynamic brake. So the controls are a bit reversed to the power and dynamic brakes on this one. So is a wee bit different to what I'm normally used to, so I'm trying my best to do this one to the best I can. And what I'm gonna do, because I've learned from YouTube videos that it's only the second locomotive that should have the head end power running and not this one in front, so what I'm gonna do, just bear with me, I'm gonna go to center view and I'm gonna shut down the HEP on the leading locomotive. There we go, folks, that is now nice and much more quieter now that we shut off the HEP or head end power in the leading unit, as it should only be used on the second locomotive, of which is closest to the Amtrak rolling stock. So as where if this locomotive was solo, it would be used on this locomotive that we would be in the cab off. But when it's double-headed, like this formation Ace, it's only the second locomotive that is used for HEP, as it does make it more comfortable for the real-life engineers, as far as I know. And I just learned this through YouTube. I'm not an expert on how these trains work. I would suggest asking a real-life railroad engineer or a train driver. They may know more than what I do, but they probably will. But honestly, folks, I try to do these Let's Plays as realistic as I can. I have to remember to push A to decrease power and use D to increase power, as it's a wee bit back to front on this setup. So I'm going to use a bit of braking here. And as you may know, it does initiate the auto sander as well, and then it just eases that off. And once we are under the 45, I will take the brakes off and get to about 40 miles an hour. And what I will try and do, I did miss this crossing, but when we come to the next one, I will do the horn sequence as correctly as I can, okay? So I'm looking forward to this one, folks. I do like General Electric or GE locomotives, and I do particularly like this add-on. Although the 3D model itself does look a bit like it's been converted, the locomotives anyways, the 3D model of the GE P40DC does appear to have been converted from something like Microsoft Train Simulator, but I do like the car view. It's not accurate, and the controls are back front. It is what it is, and to be quite frankly honest, this is by DTM, and it is better than most of their older stuff that I have in my collection. Although, there is the freeware one that you can use, as that was mentioned by someone else on YouTube, and you can use that, but, and you could always use this just for AI if you wanted to, or an NPC train, but it is acceptable for what it is. Although, to be quite frankly honest, I'd just recommend getting it in Steam sale. That's just my opinion on the matter, but anyway folks, let's have some fun now and let's see what this train can do as we go full power on the Arizona Divide, and we are going to try and reach 90 miles an hour, and it should be doable as we're doing a passenger service rather than a freight train, so that should be fun. Oh, by the way folks, please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I do listen to all feedback, both positive and constructive is always welcome, you know. And I do read and respond to comments, so please do feel free to comment on the video. And feel free to hit that subscribe button if you are new. And if you are new to this channel, welcome aboard. And I do hope you will enjoy the content that I create. In fact, we're going to try the horn sequence on the next crossing here, so I'm gonna stop chatting for a wee bit, so just bear with me. Okay folks, we're just coming up to a 60 miles an hour speed limit, and I've got to admit the brakes are a bit weak on this train, so that's another pitfall to this add-on, but it's just the way it is. But brakes do kind of work, but they're not very effective, and this train is only 9 cars long, and that's excluding the second locomotive, so the brakes should be more responsive than this, as they are a bit lacking to say the least. Anyways, I'm just going to release the brakes and then reapply them again, so try and get this under 60 miles an hour. Another thing I want to mention as well, I'm not sure if it's just me, or does this car view seem a bit dark inside, considering we are doing a late morning service. I'm sure it should be brighter than this, but anyway, it's got to put the brakes on again and bring us back down, as we are entering a 40 miles an hour speed zone, and the brakes take forever to kick in, and our speed should be going down, not up. So I'm going to put it on full service just to get anything out of this one. I hope the brakes get fixed, and I do hope that by the time I cover this add-on again in another Let's Play, I'm hoping that some of these issues will be fixed. But honestly, I got this because I do like Amtrak, and I do like these GE locomotives as well. Okay, I'm actually quite surprised in a good way that the dynamic brakes do work considerably well on this train. As with some other trains, they either work very badly or not at all. And we do have another NPC train coming towards us, and that is another freight. And that just uses default stock that comes with this route. So, folks, you only need this Amtrak GE P40DC add-on to play this scenario. Everything else in this scenario that I've made is supplied with the route, so you don't need anything else to use this. So I've done this to help those that are new to Train Simulator and may not be able to afford all of the add-ons and stuff. So I tried to keep it flexible and to make my content that I create easily accessible for everybody. But I'll do some scenarios that do require more downloads, and I like to create something for everyone, you know. So I thought I'd do this one just to use this train pack on this route. And I'm just going to take off the dynamic brake a bit more just to allow us to gain more speed, as we are going downhill. So I'm just taking off the dynamic brake and I'm going to let gravity do the work. And we are coming up to a crossing, folks, so I'm going to do two long, and as I get nearer to the crossing, I will do the short blast, and then we'll do the final horn as we go over the crossing. And another thing I've learned as well is that the maximum the horn should be sound is just no more than 10 seconds between each sequence, so I'm glad I've got that correct, so I'm happy with that. We can cancel the bell now. And it is nice to do a passenger run for a change on this route, as it's mostly freight that I've done in past Let's Plays. And as you know, most of my Let's Plays now, as by popular request, are with no narration. So this one is an exception. So I've done this one with narration just for a nice change, you know. Anyways, I do like to make these videos to make them enjoyable for you, so that's the plan. And I've got to put the dynamic brake back on again just to keep our speed nice and down as we're going down this hill. Well, I may have to use the air brakes if I need to, as we are slightly over speed here, but that's just the way it is. Okay, once we're through these twisty parts of the route, we should be able to go faster again. And we've got about 45 miles to go before we reach Winslow, as that's where we're going today, folks. And we might be held at a signal, I don't know, as I've done some creative works with the NPC traffic, and we will be routed over to the platform this time around, so that will be different for this scenario as well, as I like to add something different and interesting. But I've made this one simple. There is no trains to follow, so that should all be grand. And then when I do some more scenarios, I will make some that are a bit harder. And we do have a working alert on this train as well, but it seems to be a bit fast, as I don't know if you've heard the alerter go off in some of the other trains that I've used, especially those that use searchlight simulation sounds, of which are the Jivo sounds and the sounds that do come with the, well, for the Dash 9s, even the Dash 8s that use those sounds. with mods and stuff that I've used, the alerter plays a lot slower. This one does seem to be a bit speeded up. So, in all honesty, folks, I have to say this, and it should be more realistic than that. All they've got to do is slow down the tempo of the alerter, and it will be far more realistic. Anyway, folks, just observing the map at the bottom of the screen, just cancel that again. I've got another NPC freight train, but anyway, as I was saying, just observing the map, we will be able to go fast again very soon. In fact, we can now. So I'm going to take that dynamic brake off and put the power back into idle, just to allow the electric brake to cancel out, and then we can add the power again, go up to notch 4, and hopefully by the time we reach the 75 miles an hour speed zone, we should be able to really open up the park and enter the 75 miles an hour zone without breaking the speed limit. I'm hoping this method will work. So once we get to the top of the summit, of which is just any minute now, I'm going to open up the park, I'm going to go full notch 8, and fingers crossed, not going too fast by the time we pass that 75 miles an hour speed board. So I'm hoping I've pulled this off right, but if not, it don't matter. I'm going to keep the power on because we're just entering the 70 miles an hour, 75 miles an hour speed zone anyway, and this will go up to 90 miles an hour. So we're going to be going fast for a bit anyways, and I really am looking forward to it. Okay, borderline overspeed, but who cares? Let's just have some fun, folks. So enjoy the ride, enjoy the sounds, and I'll talk to you when we're through this fast bit, okay? Okay folks, let's have some fun now. Let's see if we can get this up to 110 miles an hour. I'm gonna go for that. Let's just cancel that alerter that keeps going off at random intervals. So, another thing I've noticed about this as well, unlike the scripts that comes with the Searchlight Simulation sound add-on, or most other General Electric or GE locomotives, the alerter is not interlinked with the movement of the controls, so you have to press Q to cancel it, otherwise it will throw the brakes. It doesn't seem to recognize movement of the throttle or sounding the horn or cancelling it. Well, apart from cancelling it with a Q key, it doesn't recognize any movement of the controls. I can give it a try, but I don't think it's just going to work. Anyways, we're just topping out at 98 miles an hour. We are on full notch 8. We really are crashing this locomotive. I was hoping to do. Okay, just to correct myself there, it does work. So you move a control and it does cancel, so that's grand. At least that's something that does work on this locomotive. So that's grand, but the tempo of the sound sequence needs to be slowed down, as it's beeping a bit too fast for the realism, at least in my opinion. But anyways, we're doing about 100 miles an hour in a 90 zone, but you know what, I just want to have some fun, folks, and really give this a thrashing across Arizona. It's just fun, you know. And we're doing 101. Let's see if we can get this up to 110 then, shall we, folks? Okay, coming up to a crossing now. So let's turn on the bell, blow the first horn, then we'll do the second one, then we'll do the third one, which is a short blast. And as we get closer to the crossing, and because we're going over 100 miles an hour, that won't take too long, as the final horn won't be longer than 10 seconds, so that's grand. And we'll cancel the bell as we are clear of the crossing. So really am enjoying myself here, folks. In all honesty, it's not a bad add-on. It might not be for the purists. The 3D model may look like it's come from Microsoft Train Simulator, but I do like the cab view. And it is more functional than some of the other cab views. And I think you can open the cab window as well. I'll just have a look at that now for you. But I'll keep my eye on the alerter just to make sure that it doesn't throw us off guard. So once this NPC train is cleared, we're going to check around the cab and have a look around, folks, as I think it's going to be great fun. And that's a Dash 8B just passing us with a trailer load. Sadly, no cab occlusion. Just cancel that alerter again. I can turn it off with Control and D. You can disable it if you want to, but I like to have it on, as it does add a layer of realism to the simulation. And yes, folks, you can open this one as well, and you can open the cab door if you want to, although I don't think there's any creaking of the door or any audio on it, but you can open and close it, which is grand. That's a nice touch from DTM, who makes this add-on. So I'm just going to cancel that alerter again. We're currently doing 104, folks, so I think we're really pushing this GE P40DC to the absolute limit. So I think it tops out and it's governed to run at 103, if my memory serves me correctly. But we're doing 104, so we're going downhill as well. So once we get on level ground again, that might change. So cancel that alerter again. It is a bit repetitive, but if I don't move a control within a minute or so, it does go off. But you can use move the throttle up and down to cancel the alerter as well, and not just rely on the Q key. As well as some other trains, moving the controllers has really no effect, but thankfully this one does, so at least that script works, even if some of the other scripts are a bit buggy. But I don't mind tapping Q every time it goes off. So we're currently doing 105 here, folks, so we really are having some fun here. But all in all, folks, I really am enjoying myself. So as you know, I do these Let's Plays for fun, and I'm going to ease off the power now, just to coast, and we are coming to level ground with a slight uphill incline, so we will lose speed anyways. So I've been breaking the speed limit here, folks, for about possibly the best of 5 to 10 minutes, but who cares, let's just have some fun, and that's what Train Simulator should be all about. That's just the way I am. I like to have fun, and I'll kick on the dynamic brake just to bring this train down to the 90 miles an hour speed limit, and that will probably change very soon to something lower as we get closer towards Winslow. In all honesty, folks, it does look like it's something from Microsoft Train Simulator in terms of the modelling and that, but personally, I'd purchase this park more for the rolling stock and that, because I do have some planned scenarios to do. And thankfully, that was just perfect timing, as there's no external audio sign for the alerter, and not even a message popping up on the screen. So, thankfully, that was just perfect timing to get back in the cab and cancel the alerter, otherwise we would have had a brake application. And I'm going to try not to, well, do my best to avoid those if I can. So, we put the power back on, we're going way too slow now, so didn't need to use the air brakes. Dynamic brakes are quite effective on this locomotive. They're a bit slow to kick in, but once they do the job, and they do work better on this locomotive compared to some others that I've covered in past Let's Plays of Train Simulator Classic. And, folks, I do have more Let's Plays to cover of Train Sim World as well, as I want to cover more of the Cajon Pass. And hopefully some more BNSF groups that hopefully will come in the future for Train Sim World 3, as I do like that game. But the reason I'm covering Train Simulator Classic is because I do have more options available to me, and I have the ability to create my own scenarios without so many limitations. So that's just my preferences, why I do prefer to play this one. And I've been doing quite a few Let's Plays and covering American Truck Simulator and Euro Truck Simulator 2 as well, as I like to make the channel quite diverse in terms of transport simulator games. That's part of what this channel is all about. So anyway, folks, just coming up to another crossing, so I'm going to turn on the bell and we will do the horn sequencer again. Okay, so we've covered the crossing there, so I'm going to go into external view. Let's have a listen to the bell. Actually, there is a bell externally on this train as well, and the horn. It's okay. It's not great. It's not as good as that one on the True Simulations enhancement pack for the GE P42DC, and I've covered that in the past Let's Play, of which should be on the channel in a playlist under simulation, so please feel free to check that out when you're ready. You'll find it in the playlist, folks. Just search for Amtrak on my channel and it should come up. Anyway, folks, let's get the power back on. We're going way too slow now, and I'll try and keep as close to 90 miles an hour as I can. Anyway, folks, we've just got under 25 miles to go before we reach Winslow. Oh, by the way, folks, just to let you know, is that you have to drive in reverse for this one. So to increase the park, press D. To decrease the park, you press A. So if you're used to playing Microsoft Train Simulator, so this will be no big deal for those who play Microsoft Train Simulator or Open Rails, as that's how the controls are configured. But for most of the other trains and stuff, the controls are reversed compared to all of the other stock and that. So just keep that in mind if you decide to get this add-on for yourself. Just cancel that alerter again. But anyway, folks, do hope you are enjoying this journey. I certainly am. Okay, folks, we've just got just under 19 miles to go before we reach Winslow, and it has been quite a nice run in my opinion. So we are due to arrive at Winslow at 11:05, and the maximum NPC trains I do have in this scenario is 9, and I've done that to keep the frames to a acceptable level without any risk of lag. And I've just used a small amount of static contents in the train yards as well. As you know, I like my content to be accessible to everybody, and I do respect the fact that not everyone has a powerful computer, so I do cater for those as well, as I want everyone to enjoy my content. Although I'll do various types of content, some with just one download like this one, that's all that's required to play this scenario, and I do others where more than possibly about 5 or 6 downloads are required at least as a minimum, as I really do vary the traffic and stuff just to make it more entertaining and enjoyable. Anyways, just had to use a dynamic brake there just to bring us down, as we were going a wee bit fast. In fact, I just realised it changed to 80 miles an hour. I always seem to get caught off guard with that lower speed limit of 80 miles an hour, as well, we're now back in the 90 zone, so let's take off the dynamic brake and idle the park, and then we can go to notch 4 just to bring us back up to 90 miles an hour again. Well, folks, we are currently got just under 7 miles to go before we reach Winslow. That was quite a nice run, actually, if you ask me. I really did enjoy this one. Let's cancel that alerter again. By the way, folks, if you just press Control and Q, you can turn off. Actually, just to correct myself there, if you press Control and D, you can disable the alerter if you don't want it on. And that just turns off the alerter, but I prefer to have it on, so I'm going to turn it back on. But that's another option this train does give you as well. So I've got a caution signal there, so I'm just going to tab. And we do have a permission denied, so I think we are running a wee bit early there, so I just have to wait for a train to clear, and then that'll be very much us done. And I think, to be honest, we were doing a speed run, although obviously in the actual scenario you would be going a bit slower, so it won't mean you won't be held at a signal like I will be. But because I did the 100 to 105 miles an hour speed run back in the 90 miles an hour speed zone earlier in this let's play, that's the reason why we're going to be held at a red signal. But once you, but when you play this for yourself and you stick to the speed limit, you'll be okay. In fact, I'm going to start doing the dynamic brake. I have to remember to press A to use the dynamic brake and use D to increase power, as the controls are reversed on this mod. This add-on. Excuse me, I'm just so excited. I'm really happy with this, and I just wanted to do a scenario based on the 1990s for this type of locomotive that would be seen in the early 1990s with the Santa Fe locomotives, you know. And it's nice to do something different. So I'm going to apply a full emergency brake application here, and there's a reason for that. Because if I don't do this, the chances are we will run the red signal, and we definitely don't want that. So I'm going to reset the train, and I'm going to ease up and edge up to the signal so that we do not breach the red signal and get in the way of the NPC train, as we will be routed off to the left from here, folks. So that's the reasons why we're being held at the signal. Anyway, so I'm going to reset the train, and then we will proceed onwards. Okay, just using notch 3 here to get us going. I'm going to ease up and edge up to the signal, and I'll just approach it slowly so I can slow down in time, as the air brakes on this train are quite weak, and I don't want to pass the signal and get in the way of the NPC train that will be passing us very soon. So we don't want that, so I'm just going to approach with caution and use a bit more power just to get us over this hill. So apart from that, should be a very straightforward run into Winslow once that NPC train has cleared. But as long as you stick with the speed limit, you will not have to wait at this red signal. But if you do what I did and do a speed run, then you probably will get held at this red signal. So just keep that in mind if you decide to do this scenario for yourself, and it is available in the Steam Workshop. So This is kind of a work in progress, but the final scenario will be nicely polished for when it's released to the public, as I do like to make sure that all my creations work effectively and fully with no issues, as I do believe in quality over quantity. Now folks, coming up to about 18.5 miles, that'll be enough just to get us up to the signal, and I'm going to start slowing down now just so that we don't go past this signal at danger. Okay folks, I had to do an emergency brake application. I was determined I was not going to pass that red signal. As to the reason is, you will find out very soon what will happen if you do cross that signal. And basically, that is how I've parked some of the trains, just to make this scenario interesting. It is an easy difficulty and you won't be held here too long, but once this train has cleared, we should be on our way into Winslow, and that will be where this let's play and of course this scenario will finish. So please do let me know your thoughts on this scenario and this let's play and what you think to this add-on. Of course there is mixed reviews, both positive and negative, and to be quite frankly honest, the DTM content I do own and I have purchased in the past, it is a bit basic to say it nicely, but this is one of the best ones that I have. Even though a 3D model of the GE P40DC may not be the best, and there is a freeware enhancement that utilizes the P42DC by Dovetail Games, as where this one is made by DTM, and it does look a bit like something from Microsoft Train Simulator, but that's just my opinion. For the passenger cars, they are nice, and that's what I purchased this pack for, and I do like the cab view on this one, and I do like the sirens as well, although some of the sirens are a bit mono, but they do the job, and that's part of the experience. Anyways, all in all, this signal should clear, and once it does, we can then proceed into the station. We do have a caution now, so we'll cancel that alerter. And the only reason that went off is because I do have the reverser in forwards, and I'm just going to wait for the brakes to release, and then we can proceed as normal. Okay, folks, I hope you enjoyed that one. We're just coming into Winslow. I just want to say to you, you stayed with me through to the end of this Let's Play. Big thank you for your support and for watching all the way through. It's much appreciated. As always, please feel free to let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. I do read and respond to all comments. Until next time, folks, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and I will see you in the next one. Okay, folks, that's all for now. I will see you in the next one.